Erica Stringer-Reasor graduated from Auburn University in 2004 with a biomedical sciences degree. In 2015, she became a hematology and oncology faculty member at the UAB's School of Medicine with clinical interest in breast cancer, women's health, developmental therapeutics, and targeted therapeutics.
The way I see success and the long road and path to being a physician is actually having a good foundation and a good support system. It began with my parents actually sending us to small private schools so that we can have an intimate setting where we can have enriched learning. The second thing is, having parents, role models, mentors to be present at the moment. And I definitely attribute my parents to being there for me during my successes, cheering me on, and also during my failures, encouraging me to get right back up.
She was a biomedical sciences major at Auburn. It's a really tough major. It's not for sissies. It's not to increase your GPA, but it's very rigorous, but it's very good preparation for medical school. And she was just a very, very good student. You don't have to talk to her long to just know that you're talking to a really intelligent person. She is did a fellowship at the University of Chicago. And she is working at some of the cutting edge that's going on in medicine. I think there's a day it'll come when we'll look back at how we practice some medicine and think, we really did that to people? Was that barbaric? Particularly in terms of chemotherapeutic treatments, because they are such a shotgun approach. But she is working at the interface of genetics and pharmacology. She works in an area that's called pharmacogenomics. Which isn't just making the medicine for the particular disease, but the particular person with the particular disease, which is just unbelievable. It is where medicine is going, and she's there, and she has the intellect to do it.
Erica's tireless research and dedication in the field of cancer research is bringing us one step closer to finding a cure for this disease.
I found it interesting that most people, from females to males, have about 99% of the same DNA. And you wonder about that 1% or so that causes people to have cancer and others not to have cancer. You think about what turns those genes on. Is it something that they were exposed to? Is it socioeconomic? Is it lifestyle? And I wanted to know more about that. I wanted to know what I could take from the laboratory and formulate hypotheses into why some people have these genes that turn on and cause cancer and the other ones don't. You know, what is the rationale? And that drives me every day, is to know the why, you know, and figure out the pathway to overcoming this resistance and stopping this cycle of this disease. I believe the field of medicine is ever evolving, and you always have to be a student in this field. You always have to allow yourself to be a conduit to learn and never stop learning. And I think that that's one of the most exciting things about the field of medicine is medications are changing, techniques are changing. You know, we're closer and closer to finding cures to cancer, but we just have to be persistent and ask questions. And so that's what I'm most excited about in the future, is to continue to do research, continue to collaborate with some of the basic scientists to sit there, listen, brainstorm about how we can make things better. Because I believe if we are able to train up mentors and younger physician scientists that are asking these questions, that we're bound to find the answer.
Erica has accomplished so much in such a short amount of time, and her Auburn experience has helped her continue to advance in the field of pharmacogenomics and cancer research.
For Erica to have achieved as much as she has in the short time she's had to do it, relatively short time, because you're talking about a long term that she was training. I mean, she's just been at UAB for a couple of years. But the fact is that she had to go to medical school, then she had to do a residency, and then I think she did two fellowships. And so time is an essence, and it also takes time to get these things up and going. And so I just think she's so deserving because it's rare that people can accomplish what she has in such a short time. And also to be working at the frontier where not everything always works well. And that's where she lives, and she's done it.
This is a very special honor to receive this Alumni Achievement Award. You know, I attribute Auburn with giving me great resources, great mentorship, great encouragement, a lot of excitement and extramural activities while I attended the school. And I feel that I continue to network with the prior alumni and students at Auburn. And I think that that's a wonderful core. You know, you can receive many awards during your lifetime, but there are some awards that are just very dear to you and are very special. And this award is received with such great honor to know that where I began, my Auburn family is recognizing my achievements. And I hope to continue to be able to stay involved and to mentor other young students that may be in my shoes right now, asking what questions to ask and how can I have set some successes. And I hope to give them that same encouragement that my Auburn family has given me.